So good morning. Let us begin with the meet. Up till now, while discussing contents from chapter 1, chapter 2, first half part of chapter 3, we discussed few mechanical properties of matter. In first chapter, we studied properties of solid state. In second chapter, we studied properties of liquid state of matter, and Patil madam has already started chapter 3 first half, where she discussed with you the mechanical properties of gaseous state of matter. Second half of chapter 3 deals with thermal properties of matter. To begin with the new chapter, before proceeding for the new chapter, I just want to revise the contents in second half of chapter 3. That is from point 3.10, page number 64, up to last of the chapter. So today we will revise about thermal properties of matter. I already have launched videos, given assignments based on these thermal properties. I hope everyone has gone through this all and has solved the assignment in the notebook. Today I am just taking the revision. So open page number 64 of the book. On page number 64, from point 3.10 till the end of the chapter, we will discuss about thermal properties of matter. So, the name suggests itself, radiation. So, what is radiation? To radiate means to give out, to spread out. Radiation is energy given out in the form of electromagnetic wave. The energy in the form of EM wave might be of different types. It might be light energy, it might be solar energy, it might be heat energy. In this chapter, we will restrict our discussion only about thermal radiations. Means thermal energy in the form of electromagnetic wave concerned with heat. So that energy thermal in the form of EM waves is invisible. वो हम लोगों को दिखती नहीं है. Secondly, energy heat in the form of electromagnetic wave is called radiant energy. हम लोग खाली रेडिएंट एनर्जी के बारे में ये चैप्टर सेकंड हाफ में डिस्कशन करेंगे. सो इन दिस यूनिट वी विल स्टडी द बिहेवियर ऑफ मैटर इफ रेडिएंट एनर्जी हीट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ईएम वेव्स इज इंसिडेंट ऑन इट. ऑल्सो वी विल स्टडी द बिहेवियर ऑफ द मैटर इफ इट इटसेल्फ is behaving as a source of radiant energy. ये दोनों हम लोगों को सीखना है. So to begin with, we will start with point 3.10.1. On page 65, हम लोग अभी रिविजन चालू करेंगे पेज नंबर 65, 3.10.1. So whenever everyone, I hope, has opened the टेक्स्ट बुक ओपन करो। टेक्स्ट बुक में पेज नंबर 65 पॉइंट नंबर 3.10.1। आई एम जस्ट टेकिंग ओनली द रिविजन, द कंटेंट्स गो थ्रू द वीडियोज आई हैव ऑलरेडी पोस्टेड ऑन 9th of July टू हैव द डिटेल अबाउट दिस रेडिएशन। पहला पॉइंट हम लोग क्या करेंगे, वी विल स्टडी इंटर रिएक्शन ऑफ मैटर इफ रेडियंट एनर्जी हीट एनर्जी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ईएम वेव्स इज इंसिडेंट ऑन इट। सो आउट ऑफ टोटल एनर्जी इंसिडेंट दैट ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ द मैटर एब्सॉर्ब्स अ लिटिल रिफ्लेक्ट्स अ लिटिल एंड रिमेनिंग पार्ट इट ट्रांसमिट्स थ्रू इट। जो एनर्जी इंसिडेंट होती है ना रेडिएंट एनर्जी, सम पार्ट गेट्स एब्सॉर्ब गेट्स ट्रांसमिटेड एंड सम पार्ट गेट्स रिफ्लेक्टेड। सो इफ क्यू इज द टोटल अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी इंसिडेंट ऑन इट, फ्रैक्शन ऑफ एनर्जी क्यू ए एब्सॉर्ब फ्रैक्शन ऑफ एनर्जी क्यू आर रिफ्लेक्टेड एंड फ्रैक्शन ऑफ एनर्जी क्यू टी लेट बी ट्रांसमिटेड पासेस थ्रू इट। If you divide this equation by Q, then we get 1 is equal to A plus R plus T, where A coefficient of absorption, R coefficient of reflection, and coefficient of transmission. So addition of all these coefficients is always 1. Coefficient of absorption is defined as the amount of energy radiant absorbed by the body to the radiant energy total incident on it. The same way you can define coefficient of reflection and coefficient of transmission. So always remember A plus R plus T is always 1. Sometimes the question is asked, define all these coefficients and state the relation between them. This is that relation. So, few bodies are good absorber. They absorb maximum amount of energy incident on it. That time value of A is much larger in comparison to R and T. Suppose R and T both are 0. Then A is 1 means it is poor reflector and poor transmitter. It is best absorber. Sometimes for the body, because this constant depend on nature of the surface on which radiation is incident. So वो क्या होता है, कभी कभी AR 0 है और T is 1. So it is good transmitter. The body through which heat radiations can easily pass are called diathermous. And the body which is opaque, not allowing the heat energy to transmit through it, is called a thermanus. So depending on the values, you can divide the surfaces, the matter, into number of groups. We will focus upon good absorber. ये लगो R की 0 है तो A will be 1, so it will be good absorber. So it will absorb maximum amount of energy incident on it and behaves as absorber. Absorb होने के बाद क्या होता है, due to absorption of energy its temperature will increase and to maintain the temperature equilibrium it has to re-emit the energy it has absorbed. जो एनर्जी एब्जॉर्ब की है वो उसको एमिट करनी पड़ेगी, सो दैट वी विल गेट टेम्परेचर इक्विलिब्रियम। सो गुड एब्जॉर्बर इज गुड एमिटर, रिमेंबर ऑल दिस पॉइंट्स। वेयर जो एब्जॉर्बर अच्छे है ना वो एमिटर भी अच्छे है, उनको एमिट करनी पड़ती है ऑन देयर ओन रेडिएशंस। सो द बॉडी विच एब्जॉर्ब्स all radiant energy incident on it is called perfectly black body. Any surface which is able to absorb almost all energy radiant incident on it will behave as perfectly black body. And this body being good absorber also behaves as good emitter. So these are together. For practical purposes, no body we will get which is perfectly black body. Ideal body कौन सी भी नहीं होती है. So the scientist Ferry has designed perfectly black body for all practical purposes. I have switched over to point 3.11.1. 3.11.1 page number 66. इसके ऊपर मैं गई हूँ. Perfectly black body मैंने बोला जो absorb कर सकते हैं वो radiate emit भी कर सकते हैं. और परफेक्टली ब्लैक बॉडी इज एनी सरफेस ऑफ द मैटर विच इज कैपेबल ऑफ एब्जॉर्बिंग ऑल रेडिएंट एनर्जी इंसिडेंट ऑन इट विच ऑलवेज बिहेव्स एज गुड एमिटर टू. फॉर प्रैक्टिकल पर्पजेस फेरी हैज डिजाइन ब्लैक बॉडी कंस्ट्रक्टेड ब्लैक बॉडी एंड दैट ब्लैक बॉडी दे हैव शोन इन फिगर 3.4. सो जनरली द क्वेश्चन इज आस्क्ड define perfectly black body, explain construction and working of Ferry's black body. So Ferry black body में क्या होता है, it is double wall hollow sphere having a small opening. The radiant energy enters this sphere through this small opening. Its inner surface is coated with lamp black and outer surface is made silver polish. It has projection, conical projection, exact opposite the opening so that normal incidence of radiant energy is avoided. It suffers multiple internal reflection and during each reflection 98% of energy gets absorbed. So within second the entire energy is absorbed. No energy is allowed to leave the sphere once it enters the Ferry's black body. So this is Ferry's black body. So what happens when black body absorbs it? It is capable of emitting heat, isn't it? Because its temperature will rise and temperature should be maintained constant. So up till now we discussed behavior when radiant energy is incident on the matter. Now we will consider the matter itself as a source of radiant energy. It will emit the radiant energy. It is true for all bodies. Each and every body is capable of emitting radiant energy to its surrounding, to its neighbor. ये तो सच ही है. तो हम लोग अभी क्या करेंगे, along with absorption we will consider the behavior of matter if itself is behaving as a source of radiant energy that gives you heat exchange between body and its surrounding. एक body है वो एक surrounding में रखी है. Surrounding will the body is exposed to surrounding, so radiant energy incident from the surrounding it will absorb. But being the good emitter at the same time the body will start emitting energy. So there is heat exchange between the body and the surrounding. The energy absorbed by body through unit area per unit time. जितनी energy unit area से body में 1 second absorb हो जाती है, it is called its emissive power, denoted by symbol R. I have switched over on page number 67 देखो last line, emissive power or it is also called radiant energy. I am just summarizing the chapter. Everyone has to go through the videos posted, go through the book and get the points well. अभी क्या मैं बोला, radiant energy या emissive power के बारे में मैं बात कर रही हूँ. So energy radiated out through unit area in unit time is called emissive power of given body. It is observed at given temperature, emissive power of perfectly black body is maximum. ये फॉर्मूला ध्यान रखना है. रेडिएंट एनर्जी गिवन आउट एमिटेड थ्रू यूनिट एरिया पर यूनिट टाइम इज कॉल्ड एमिसिव पावर ऑफ गिवन बॉडी. आउट ऑफ ऑल नोन बॉडीज एट गिवन टेम्परेचर परफेक्टली ब्लैक बॉडी हैज मैक्सिमम एमिसिव पावर एंड हेंस रेडिएशन रेडिएंट एनर्जी एमिटेड बाय बॉडी इज कंपेयर्ड विथ रेडिएंट एनर्जी एमिटेड बाय perfectly black body maintained at same temperature. The ratio of radiant emissive power of body to emissive power of perfectly black body is called coefficient of emission at that particular temperature. Because radiant energy emitted, emissive power is a function of temperature. So when you relate all these things, you have to maintain both these bodies at given temperature. ये हम लोगों को temperature maintain करना है. So you will get one more constant, coefficient of emission of the body. And experimentally, theoretically, it is proved coefficient of absorption is equal to coefficient of emission of the same body at the given temperature. The law is stated as Kirchhoff's law. Kirchhoff scientists studied this heat exchange and derived the law A is equal to E. So I have moved to point number 3.13. I have covered 3.12.1. Emissive power मैंने बोला ना, coefficient of emission वो मैंने कवर किया. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एमिसिविटी. आई हैव स्विच ओवर टू द रिलेशन बिटवीन ए एंड ई विच इज किरचॉफ्स लॉ ऑफ हीट रेडिएशन. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू किरचॉफ्स लॉ वी कैन रिलेट ए एंड ई टूगेदर. ए इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू ई. व्हेन बॉडी बिहेव्स एज सोर्स ऑफ रेडिएंट एनर्जी देन radiant energy is the function of temperature. If the temperature of the body is large, then energy radiated, emitted by the body will be of greater amount. So it is the function of temperature. Emissive power means what? Energy through unit area in 1 second, unit time. Total energy radiated through area A in time t will be then Q in R into AT, because R is Q by AT. So remember these points. So radiant emissive power and out of all known bodies at given temperature, perfectly black body is considered ideal. So all these laws, Kirchhoff's law, dependence of R, emissive power of on temperature, which is called Stefan-Boltzmann law. So I am now talking about point 3.15. 3.15 है ना, इसके बारे में मैं बात कर रही हूँ. So we have switched over to point 3.15 on page number 71. So this R, that is energy radiated, rate of emission means R, emissive power, is the function of temperature. And he stated, both of them stated the law for perfectly black body. You remember this well. This is for only perfectly black body. And they proved emissive power of perfectly black body, radiant energy emitted per unit area in unit time is proportional to 4th power of its absolute temperature. This constant of proportionality is called Stefan-Boltzmann constant sigma T raised to 4. But you know this is for perfect black body. If you have to apply the law for any ordinary body at any temperature, only except absolute zero, एब्सोल्यूट जीरो टेम्परेचर है तभी कौन सी भी बॉडी एनर्जी रेडिएट नहीं करेगी, एमिट नहीं करेगी. सो फॉर ऑर्डिनरी बॉडीज यू हैव टू मॉडिफाई दिस अ लिटिल, यू हैव टू टेक ई सिग्मा टी बाय टू ऑर्डिनरी एंड दिस इज फॉर परफेक्टली ब्लैक बॉडी. यू हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई दिस विद कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ एमिशन, द फ्रैक्शन ऑफ रेडिएंट एनर्जी of body with respect to perfectly black body. So this is general statement of Stefan's Boltzmann law for perfectly black body and for ordinary body. So you can use these laws and you can have the explanation for why body cools when kept in hotter surrounding gains energy, becomes hot, and why body cools if kept in comparatively surrounding at lower temperature. इसमें मैंने body रखी which is at higher temperature. So the surrounding energy is incident on it. So rate of absorption चालू है, उस time वो emit भी कर रही है, so rate of emission भी चालू है. But when temperature is large, being proportional to T raised to 4, rate of absorption, energy radiant absorbed by the body through entire area in given time will be less than the energy given by the body through entire area for the same given time. The rate of emission being greater than rate of absorption, body will start cooling. दोनों एक साथ चालू रहते हैं, हीट एक्सचेंज बिटवीन ऑकर्स एंड हीट एब्जॉर्ब और एमिटेड इज गिवन बाय स्टीफन्स बोल्ट्जमैन लॉ. सो दिस कैन ऑल्सो बी एक्सप्लेन यूजिंग स्टीफन्स बोल्ट्जमैन लॉ. सो व्हेन देर इज लॉस ऑफ एनर्जी बाय द बॉडी केप्ट इन द सराउंडिंग, टेम्परेचर ऑफ द बॉडी डिक्रीजेस एंड इट कूल्स. When there is gain of energy during heat exchange between body and the surrounding, cooler body kept in hotter surrounding, rate of absorption greater than rate of emission, so net gain of energy and temperature of the body increases. This heat exchange continues till the temperature or thermal equilibrium is maintained between the two. ये हीट एक्सचेंज चालू ही रहता है. जब भी दोनों के टेम्परेचर सेम है तभी रेट ऑफ एमिशन इज सेम एज रेट ऑफ एब्जॉर्प्शन, बट हीट एक्सचेंज नेवर स्टॉप्स, इट कंटिन्यूज एंड कंटिन्यूज ओनली. सो दिस इज द पॉइंट. एंड द एनर्जी विच इज रेडिएटेड बाय द हॉट बॉडी इन इट्स सराउंडिंग इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ईएम वेव्स. Number of EM waves generate from this body. बहुत सारे EM waves है, having different values of wavelengths, lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, lambda 4, etc. The body does not radiate energy only through one wave having particular wavelength. But at the same time, number of EM waves are emitted from the body of different wavelengths. And it is observed experimentally, proved experimentally, in one particular wave, the energy radiated has maximum value. And relation between energy radiated wavelength and temperature of the body is given by Wien's displacement law. I have switched over to 3.14.1. On page 70 page pe dekho 3.14.1 Wien's displacement law hai. It relates wavelength having maximum energy in emission with temperature of the body. Body ke temperature se wo relate karti hai. And according we get energy possessed by wavelength as a function of temperature, inversely proportional to temperature. So lambda max into temperature is always constant, which is called Wien's constant, given by symbol B. So this law is very useful to determine temperature of distant bodies, star, sun, and उनके temperatures भी हम लोग ये law से निकाल सकते हैं. If you plot a graph of energy radiated through maximum wavelength with respect to temperature, energy is maximum at one particular wavelength, lambda. If temperature is increased, nature of graph does not change. But temperature increased here, so wavelength having maximum energy shifts towards the left. So wavelength goes on reducing. So this is called energy spectrum. It is on point 3.14. अभी 3.14 है वो देखो, and the diagram 3.5. वो point मैंने अपन cover कर रही हूँ. As temperature is increased, nature of graph does not change. Only the wavelength of maximum in radiant energy emitted shifts towards left. So this is spectral distribution of black body, and using this Wien scientist stated displacement law. So lambda max T is always constant, and that's value is Wien's constant. So this is the summary of second half of chapter 3. You just go through the book again, try to solve your numerics. Next time we will proceed further with the new chapter. I am closing the meet for all.